Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is gonna be kind of similar to one that I've done before. Somebody on Instagram actually asked me if I had a video like this filmed, and the answer was no, so I thought that's actually a really good idea. Let me go ahead and film it. And what that is basically just going to be my favorite journal shops. So my favorite shops to purchase journal supplies, everything you kind of see here. I did do a similar video like this, but for planner stuff. So like my favorite minimal stickers and minimal sticker shops. And since I did that like 4 months ago, I thought, duh, a video about journal shops would be perfect. So a couple things before I get started. This is not going to be every single journal shop I've ever purchased from ever. If you want to see a complete super long list, I actually have one on my journal highlight on my Instagram page, which is at Amanda Lee Plans. This is just going to be my top favorite shops that I purchase from repeatedly. I love their stuff, just kind of like my main shops. So like I said, there are some other ones out there that I also like, but if I said everything, this would be like a really long video. So this is just gonna be my top shops. And if you wanna see more, like I said, check out that highlight. And then the second thing I wanna mention, this is kind of unique to the journal world. It's not so much in the planner kind of world, but this is gonna be shops, not brands. So those are two different things. There are shops out there that carry a variety of brands. And just to kind of give like an example, I guess, these letterpress cards are from the brand Classic Key. And multiple shops sell these, and a handful of shops on my list today sell these, but they're a specific brand. So that's kind of like how the journal world is. Like there's different stationery brands and many shops sell the various stationery brands. So I'm gonna be like talking about that. You'll kind of see once I get started, but I just wanted to make that note as well. Some of the shops towards the end do actually mainly carry and make all their own products, but I'll differentiate, of course, based on the shop. So the first shop that I want to highlight is, if you follow me on Instagram, you're not going to be surprised, that is Journal Pages. Journal Pages is literally like my favorite shop right now. These two items right here are actually from Journal Pages' own line. These are some letterpress note cards, so it's actually their own brand. But what I love about Journal Pages is they carry everything, absolutely everything. There are certain shops out there that say they carry Classic-y and Meow Illustration, but they don't carry Pion, for example. Journal Pages, for some reason, I'm telling you, they carry literally every popular stationery brand. And another thing I've noticed about Journal Pages is they tend to get items super quickly, way quicker than any other shop. They are based in Malaysia, so I'm in the United States. DHL shipping is about $24. The shipping cost goes up and down depending on how much you order and obviously the weight of your package. But for me, it's been about $24 every single order, which obviously isn't cheap, but it is coming from Malaysia. And you do what you gotta do when you wanna get your hands on stationery. So these are just kind of two examples that I wanted to show when talking about Journal Pages because it's from their actual brand, but literally go on their website, you will see every single popular brand out there. The second shop is A Blank Note. And this is actually an item that I got from A Blank Note. So this is an example of what I was just saying. This tape, this is a pet tape from the brand Pion. It might be Peon. I'm not exactly sure how it's pronounced. I've always said Pion. And this is a girl pet tape. And it's one of my favorite pet tapes ever. And I actually bought this from A Blank Note. They are a stationery shop, again, similar to Journal Pages, but A Blank Note is based in the United States. And again, they carry a lot of these stationery brands. They carry Pion, they carry Hours, just a bunch of brands. So definitely recommend their shop. They've got really fast shipping. And again, they are within the United States. So I've noticed that these stationery shops within the United States, I love them so much. They don't have as many brands as like Journal Pages does. And I think that's just because so many brands are based outside of the US. So it might be kind of difficult for United States shops to get their hands on them, but either way. And of course, everything will be linked in the description box, every single shop I talk about. The next shop I want to mention is Pinky Elephant Craft. I love Pinky Elephant Craft. They are also based in the United States. This is a stamp from the brand Meow Illustration. And this tape is actually from Meow Illustration as well. And I bought these items from Pinky Elephant Craft. It's another one of those shops that, like I said, they carry all the main popular stationery brands. Actually, these classic-y these classically letterpress cards I mentioned in the beginning, I bought those from Pinky Elephant as well. And I also bought this Yeon Charm stamp from Pinky Elephant. But again, all of these brands are like actual stationery brands, but Pinky Elephant is an amazing US-based shop that sells these brands, which is always lovely. If I can find something on a US-based shop, I will buy it there first, of course. It's only like the items that I can't find on any US shops that I'll end up going to like Journal Pages or whatever. You know, it's so tough with this like shop slash brand kind of thing, but I just felt like a video about my favorite shops would be more useful than a video about my favorite brands, because I can sit here and tell you all these brands all day and you're gonna be like, okay, great, well, but where do I buy it? Like, the brand's cute, but where do I buy it? So I thought a video about the shops would be more useful. It's almost similar to when I post on my Instagram feed. When I post a photo on Instagram, I usually tag the brand. I don't know why, it's like so difficult. It's like if I have a spread using a bunch of this stuff, I usually tag the brand versus the shop I bought it from. And then people will reply and be like, where do I buy this? Like, you know what I mean? Anyways, moving on. The next shop is Nico Nico. I'm not sure if it's Nico Nico or Nico Neko, but once again, Nico Nico is a stationery shop. They're actually based in New York City. They do have their own line of products. This is an example. This is like a calendar letterpress label book from their own brand. And then this is a stamp. It means let it be. This is from Nico Nico's own brand as well. But they are a New York City-based shop that carries, say it with me, all the big stationery brands. Nico Nico carries Pion, they carry Classic-y, they carry Black Milk Shop, they carry so many things. Yeon Charm, a million things. I highly recommend, if you're interested in this type of stationery, I highly recommend checking out all these sites. The next shop is very unique, actually. It is Blinks of Life. And Blinks of Life, they're based in Indonesia. They're based in Indonesia. But my shipping cost was about $12 and it didn't even take that long to get to me. It was only like 2 weeks. But Blinks of Life is very unique because all of Blinks of Life products are their own. So now we're switching it up. Instead of shops carrying brands, this is a stamp from Blinks of Life. It is their own brand. This is a gold foil frame letterpress card. That is also their own brand. I've only placed one order with them so far, but I love it so much, and they're coming out with like new collections and I'm very excited. So this is a transparent sticker sheet. This is also Blinks of Life and it is again their own brand. So I really, really love that about them. I mean, obviously I love having shops out there where I can find like, you know, some of the popular stationery brands, but I just think it's really cool that Blinks of Life just has such beautiful, unique products and it's all their own. Everything is their own. This one is also Blinks of Life. And then I have one more back here. Let's see if I can grab that. I really love this one. And then this flower stamp is Blinks of Life. This was a lot of stuff that I got in my most recent order. I really hope that you can see everything I'm showing because I can't really see it, just the way that the tripod's holding my phone. Anyways, the next shop I'm gonna mention is Some Things of Mine. And Some Things of Mine is also based in Malaysia, just like Journal Pages. And they're a very, very similar shop to Journal Pages in the sense that they carry other brands. Like, they have pretty much every brand, just like Journal Pages. But just like how Journal Pages has some of their own products, Some Things of Mine does as well. This is actually a collaboration. So this stamp says, Hold On To Your Faith. It's a collaboration between Poi Chin and Some Things of Mine. And then I believe these two are also part of that collaboration between the designer and the shop. And I think this one might be too, actually, this Me Time stamp. But as another like example, I got this stamp right here is from Narette. She's a designer. And I bought this stamp off of Some Things of Mine. So they do carry Narette stamps. Actually, this stamp is really cool that I got. This is Journal Page's own brand as well. It's like just like little splatters. It gives kind of a cool effect to your page. This stamp is from Janelle Atelier. I don't know exactly how to say their brand, but this is, again, a brand. And this frame stamp is sold on Journal Pages, Pinky Elephant, Some Things of Mine. So as you can see, like, there are a lot of shops that carry kind of all the same brands. So yeah, that is Some Things of Mine. The next shop I'm going to mention is one of my favorites, Raw Market Shop. So Raw Market Shop is awesome. They have a ton of their own products. Let me see if I can get this out. This is like my favorite tape of all time. Okay, this is like my favorite tape of all time. And this is from Raw Market Shop. They also have their own line of stamps, but then they do carry some stuff from brands as well. I think like I got my moon calendar from them. And I know the moon calendar isn't like Raw Market Shop's own product, so it's gotta be someone else's. But this label tape right here is one of my favorite things ever. Hope that's focusing. I hope you can see it. And this tape is from Raw Market Shop. Like I said, they also have a bunch of stamps, and I think this was from their last collection, but I think they actually just came out with a brand new collection. I think it's for pre-order right now, but I need to go take a look at that. Okay, so that is Raw Market Shop. The next shop I'm going to mention is Smita Paper. Oh, you know what I forgot to say? Raw Market Shop is based in Singapore. So the shipping, I think, was about $12, but it actually didn't even take too long. So obviously, when you're shopping with a US shop, the shipping's like probably going to be around $5. And I've noticed like Singapore, Indonesia, it's between like 12 and 16. And then Malaysia is like, I would say 12 to 24, depending on the shipping method. So I do want to mention where these shops are based, but I have obviously ordered from all of them and I have had no issues. I mean, you might have to pay a little bit more in shipping if you're based in the United States like I am, but honestly, it takes 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks max. I think the longest I had an order take to come was probably a month. But whatever, it's worth the wait. So yeah, the next shop is Smita Paper. And I actually just got my first Smita Paper order in the other day. And they are based in Indonesia as well. And this is a stamp, again, from the designer Narette. And I bought this off Smita Paper. So Smita Paper has all the Narette stamps and, again, a bunch of other brands. Pion, pretty much every brand that I've mentioned. So Smita Paper is along the lines of Some Things of Mine, Journal Pages, Nico Nico, yeah. But the reason I want to mention all of these instead of just giving you one and saying, okay, here's one, like, go take a look, is because while all these shops carry some of the same brands, sometimes they don't all have every single item. Like, they don't all have every brand or every product. A lot of them have some of their own stuff, which is really neat. And then sometimes shops get them quicker than other shops, or even bigger, something will be out of stock in one shop, but then another shop will have it. So if there's like a tape or something, say there's like a Pion tape that you like really, really, really want. This is another Pion washi tape. I can't even remember exactly which shop I got this from, but say you really want this Pion Sketch Girl washi tape and you visited Journal Pages and it's sold out, and you visited a Blank Note and it's sold out. Well, you might visit Smita Paper and it might actually be in stock. So I always make my rounds in all the shops. anyways, so after Smita Paper, now we're actually going to kind of get into... So the first half that I just went over is a lot of shops, with the exception of a few, but a lot of shops that carry other brands. Now I'm going to get into some more smaller shops that hand make, you know, their own items and their own products. Some of them are on Etsy, etc. So the first one I'm going to talk about is Sofly Studio. I actually got my first items in from Sofly Studio yesterday, and believe it or not, this was actually a giveaway. I won one of their giveaways on Instagram. I was so happy. This is her Deckled Edge A6 journal with handmade paper. And I know you're probably thinking, come on, Amanda, you've gotten one package from them and it was a freaking giveaway. Like, how can you, you know, judge this shop? Trust me, mention Sofly Studio to any journal person and they will be like, obsessed. She creates her own handmade paper. She does sell some other brand products like Mew print on stickers. Let me show you what those are like. And a ton of these brands all sell like the Mew print on stickers. She sells like a handful of other stuff. She sells Avril yarn. I really love Avril yarn. So these are two Avril yarn cones. You can get those from Journal Pages, Softly Studio, a ton of shops that I mentioned. But yeah, so Softly Studio does sell some other stuff, but I think her main thing is her own handmade items. So she makes handmade journals, handmade paper. She's got some like note cards and notepads, and it's just all super beautiful. Let me show you some of this handmade paper that came with my giveaway prize. So here's some deckled edge handmade paper. I would definitely recommend checking out Softly Studio. And if you're watching this video around the time that it goes up, so Softly Studio is actually based in Abu Dhabi, but she is currently doing free shipping. So it's a promotion. She's trying to clear out her shop to make room for some new products and stuff. So she's currently offering free shipping for international, well, anyone, but also international, which is huge because I mean, I think when I went to check out from her shop, because literally I placed an order yesterday because the free shipping promo started yesterday. It just so happened I got my giveaway prize from her yesterday. So I did place an order. And I think the shipping was $16, but if you use the code FREESHIP, then you will get obviously free shipping, which is amazing. So if you want anything from her, now is definitely the time to grab it. But yeah, so that is Softly Studio. She actually also has a YouTube channel. Highly recommend. It's so beautiful. It puts my channel to shame. The next shop I'm going to mention is Album Love Handmade. So Album Love Handmade is on Etsy. She's based in Poland. This is one of her sticker sheets. And then this is actually a pack of little cutout butterflies from her. I have gotten so many items from her. I've bought multiple times. I have stickers. I have, you know, cutouts. I've bought journal kits from her where she includes like tags, ephemera, papers, all sorts of stuff. Definitely check out her Etsy shop. Like I said, she is based in Poland, but the shipping is incredibly affordable. I think because she just ships in like a regular envelope. And to get to me in the United States, each of my orders really only took like maybe 2 weeks or so. So it wasn't bad at all. Definitely recommend her shop because she has such a unique style and she has so many items. So for sure, check her Etsy out. The next shop is Cat's Life Press. So Cat's Life Press is super fun and interesting because all these overseas shops sell Cat's Life Press, Journal Pages, Smita Paper, Some Things of Mine. They all sell Cat's Life Press. But get this, for the first time ever, Cat's Life Press is a brand based in the United States. So they're kind of famous for these like little punctuation stamps, these stamps here. Hold on. These are two more from them, the Handmade and Instant Magique. And then I also have this one as well, which is like a little postal stamp. I really, really love Cat's Life Press stamps. And I think they're like the only popular brand that's actually based in the United States, which is kind of funny. But you can order, I mean, there are, like I said, there are a lot of shops that sell them. But if you go to Cat's Life Press Instagram, they actually have a link in their bio to their website. They don't have a traditional website, like pretty much their website's like their catalog, I guess, and then you send them an email with the item number of what you want to purchase, and then they do the, like, you know, I guess billing and stuff through PayPal. So yeah, Cat's Life Press stamps are amazing. You've probably seen them if you are familiar with like the journal world at all. The next shop is Cotton Crescent. I love Cotton Crescent so much. I've purchased from her many, many times. Here are some sticker sheets from Cotton Crescent. These word stickers are my absolute favorite. I ordered a ton of sheets of these because I never want to be without them. I have word stickers from other shops, but they are just not the same. Like, these are my number one. I also have these beautiful kanji characters, which are just Chinese calligraphy characters in transparent. They are so beautiful. And then these are some calligraphy hexagons. I have a huge Cotton Crescent sticker collection, so these are only three sheets that I wanted to use as an example. But Cotton Crescent doesn't only make stickers. She also makes journals and paper bundles. So there is a lot that you can get from Cotton Crescent. So this is one of my journals from her. As you can see, it's kind of like a white mixed paper journal. There's some handmade paper. There's some book paper, all sorts of things. Super pretty. So she has a lot of different versions of her journals. This one I have already started using. Obviously, I have some spreads done in here. There's one of Cotton Crescent stickers. So yeah, I just really, really love her stuff. Definitely check her out. Cotton Crescent is based in the United States as well. She's in Florida and her shop is on Etsy. So that is Cotton Crescent. And then the next shop is Milk Tea. So I only have one sticker sheet that I pulled out from It's Milk Tea, but trust me, she has so much stuff. The last time I purchased from Milk Tea, I bought a huge paper bundle. So like it came with different handmade papers, ephemeras, yada, yada. And I think she's actually going to have a shop update soon as well. But if you go to her site now, she's got all of her stickers listed and I think some journals as well. She makes handmade journals just like Cotton Crescent. This is probably my favorite sticker sheet from It's Milk Tea. I have it in the transparent. I just think it's so pretty. Next time I place an order from her, probably her shop update, I'm literally going to order like a ton more of those. I'm always afraid to use them. But as another example, if you watched my volume one flip through of my first passport journal, this journal is from It's Milk Tea as well. So she definitely has a good variety. Again, a variety kind of similar to Cotton Crescent, where she's got stickers, paper bundles, and journals. It's Milk Tea is also based in the United States. I think she's in California, but I'm not positive, but she's definitely in the US. The next shop is Province Diary. I love Province Diary and I love Amy so much. Here are some sticker sheets from Amy, but I feel her stickers are beautiful, but Amy is like so famous for her paper bundles. If you go on her website, take a look at her paper bundles. She has the most unique like paper and ephemera bundles ever. Of course, she also offers a bunch of sticker sheets. She has a Patreon and I'm actually subscribed to her Patreon. So I signed up in May and I got my first mail in May and I loved it so much. Actually, I can show you the spread that I did with my Patreon mail from her. So she has a Patreon, but she also has a website. So, okay, so this was my spread that I did. This paper, that paper, that paper, the lace, that's all from Province Diary. And then those two stickers and the butterfly sticker is also Province Diary. She has a very vintage romantic kind of feel, which fits because she is located in France, which I just think is amazing. But I find Province Diary to be very similar with Album Love Handmade in the sense that once it ships, it actually really doesn't take that long. I mean, I've got my order in probably 2 weeks or so. So that is Province Diary. The next shop is Hartley Paper. I love Hartley Paper so much. Let me show you my favorite thing from Hartley Paper. So Hartley Paper, I would say majority of their shop is their own brand. They have their own washi, their own stickers, their own stamps even. But they do also sell some products from other brands. They sell the Mew or Mew print-on stickers. They sell Classic-y frames. This little deer stamp is from Hartley Paper. And then this is one of their washi collections. This is Ticket, Map, and Night Ticket. These are like some of my favorite washis of all time. And this is from Hartley Paper's own brand. I also grabbed this sticker sheet to show. That is also from Hartley Paper. So yeah, they are actually based in Germany. And again, I've ordered from Hartley Paper many times and it really doesn't take all that long. I think the shipping was actually increased recently, at least for tracked shipping. So you can get untracked shipping for like $6 or $7. But if you want tracked, I think it's like $24 or something from Germany. But definitely worth it. I love Hartley Paper. Excuse me. And then the very last shop I'm going to mention today is It's June Lee. And this right here is a sticker sheet from It's June Lee. She's kind of famous for like her hexagon stickers and this kind of color scheme. Super pretty, but I would say her Etsy shop is mainly filled with stickers, but she also has some frames and kind of other paper goods and paper products as well. I'm actually over here trying to find it. Oh, here we go. So this is a little pack of like frames, and that is from It's Junely as well. Very pretty. She is based in Germany also. So just like Hartley Paper, It's Junely is based in Germany. She sends her stuff though, maybe it's because she only really offers like stickers and really flat paper goods, whereas Hartley Paper has washi and kind of like thicker items. But It's Junely sends everything like regular letter, and it actually comes ridiculously fast from Germany. I noticed that with my last order. So yeah, that is everything that I had to talk about today. Like I said, there are some other shops, like Paper Plus Cloth is actually a shop based in Canada. Actually, Paper Plus Cloth, no. I think I bought this Pion tape, this floral pet tape from Pion, from Paper Plus Cloth. Yeah, I definitely did, because they were the only shop that had this in stock. See what I mean? You got to go around to all the shops until you find the item that you want. But Paper Plus Cloth is actually based in Canada. So if anyone is in Canada, I mean, I ordered from there being in the United States, and it was like, you know, totally fine. It almost felt like I was ordering from the US. But Paper Plus Cloth is one that sells a lot of the popular brands. And then there are some other little shops here and there. I think I have some stickers from Opal and Fern. So Opal and Fern does a bunch of hand-drawn stickers. So these are like, these almost remind me more of like bullet journal type stickers. I do use them in my journal spreads sometimes. I think they're so pretty. I just love her illustrations. So yeah, that's another shop. Serica Studio. Serica Studio has a YouTube channel and a really successful channel, Instagram, and shop. She sells stickers, although I think her shop might be on a break right now. So there definitely are other ones. And like I said, if you want to see the complete list, check out my Instagram highlight titled Journal. But that is it for me today. I hope this helped someone out. And if you have any questions, definitely leave them in the comment section below. Bye!